Hi, welcome to From the Study. I'm James Durkitz, the Rector of Trinity by the Sea in Port Aransas. And this is just a weekly reading from our booklet entitled, I Will Now Turn Aside. I hope you all are enjoying this as a guide to your daily prayers. It's certainly been helpful to me to know that many of us are praying through this together. Today we've got a reading from Stanley Hauerwas, who I read in seminary in my ethics class, but I've returned to his book and some of his writings and some different on a number of different occasions, and I thought this one was a really good one as we think about kind of what it means to be church while we're in this strange time. One thing that stepping away from our normal church life does is it gives us the opportunity to be reflective about what we miss and what's important about our church life together. So here we go. At Pentecost, we celebrate the birth of the church by the Holy Spirit. Pentecost is the climax of the church year, as only now we're able liturgically to tell the whole story of God's redemption of his creation. All is finally summed up through God's new creation of the church. By creating this time for people, God has storied the world, as now we have everything necessary to know the time in which we live. For God saves by making possible the existence of a people who are formed by God's time, so that the world can know that we are creatures of a good creator, formed by God's time. The Holy Spirit, to be sure, is a wild and powerful presence, creating new people where there were no people. But it is a spirit that they know and we know. For the work it is doing is not different from the work that was done in Jesus of Nazareth. Therefore, in the Gospel of John, Jesus tells his disciples that he must go so that the Counselor, the Spirit of Truth, might be present to bear witness to him. Moreover, that same witness that the Spirit makes to Jesus transforms the witness of the disciples, as they are now able to see what they have seen from the beginning, but at the same time not seen at all. To be sure, God's kingdom is more determinative than the church. Yet, at Pentecost, God storied a people with gifts so that they might be capable of witnessing to the world the renewal of our unity made possible in Jesus of Nazareth. The church's theological witness cannot help, therefore, be anything less than a challenge to the conventional wisdom of the world. For the church is involved in nothing less than offering an alternative to war by providing the world with a history by our witnesses as Christians to go making disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always to the close of ages. That's from the Hauerwas reader. And my reflection question that I pose for this day is, where in the church do you see the Holy Spirit at work, helping to shape the history of the world? And you can think of church here as our local church, or as the church universal acting in alignment with the kingdom of God. The things that stand out to me most easily, perhaps, are the things that we did after the hurricane, when we literally helped to rebuild the world around us, mostly just by our participation in the lives of people and by participating in what God was up to around us. But also something that I discovered when I came to Trinity by the Sea, and I remember noticing the sense of welcome that this community, this church family offers. And I thought, I remember thinking, if this is how they welcome people in, whomever shows up to the doors, people who attend regularly and people who show up occasionally and people who wander in for the first time, if there's this sense of welcome, then this place really is aligned with the kingdom of God and is a place that I can feel at home and work and be a priest. And part of that was for me also to learn, as I continue to learn, what it means to welcome others in. And so that's where, you know, off the top of my head, that's different from a lot of segments of our culture and our society that have different standards, different expectations of the people who they welcome in. This church welcomes in and then figures out how we're related to each other and how we can work together, as opposed to identifying differences, perhaps, the way the world does. We first see that we are God's children and we're welcomed in no matter how we're hurting or estranged or wandering or lost, and then we make this journey together. So that's where I see you all doing God's work, is the way you welcome others in and the way you welcome each other in. And I'm using language that makes more sense when we gather together. And maybe the challenge for me and us right now is to think about how to continue to welcome in, how to be that presence of God in the midst of life while we are apart, while we're separated. And I think that's lived out in our daily lives. In each of our interactions, maybe we pretend like we're standing at the church door welcoming someone in and think about how we might greet them on that porch when we happen to greet them in the grocery store line or on the street or on the beach. So that's my reflection piece, and I will end with this collect. I want to say thank you to Billy Tweedy for sitting in last week. I might have another guest read from the study another time, but it was nice to have him while I took some time away for a little refreshment. So the Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, who on this day taught the hearts of your faithful people by sending the gift, sending to them the light of your Holy Spirit, grant us by the same Spirit to have a right judgment in all things and evermore to rejoice in his holy comfort. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. God bless you. Take care. I love you and hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.